we're facing.
We've got the group picture. Yeah, and next you want to take a picture of the land.
I'm going around.
It's about 2 hours in and I'm now split off for Scapegoat, so it's gonna be just me running solo for the next 110-120 miles. On the branch of an old gum tree.
Our feet would sway to a voice in the breeze.
And birds. I got over this thing on that tree, now I gotta get back. Yeah. Looks super. Does that look easy? Scapegoat. Heading for a pass, just right there. Oh, oh yeah. This is a Bob Open classic situation here where the trail and the creek are the same thing. I'm heading for Scapegoat. A lot of cliffs up there, but it's supposed to be a way through. So there we go. Just gotta sneak just to the right of those cliffs. Get you there. Nice zone. Woo! Look at this. Scapegoat Plateau. Almost at 8,000 feet. Awesome up here. We felt the sun as it burned upon our skin. These memories will stay with me. Coming into Green Fork. Hopefully there's a line down this thing. It's a little I don't know for sure that anyone's ever been up here. I assume they have. Well, this thing definitely drops a lot of vert in a hurry here. You go for a little ride down this. Ah, maybe we will. Woo! Well, this line here's not gonna go. This'll go here. It's hard to see, but it's awfully steep. What do you know? Here be the trail. Probably won't be able to stay on it, but it's around. These north-facing aspects definitely have a lot more snow. Could slow me down. Really hoping to float straight creek tonight. That was tough. A good couple miles of snow on this side of the pass. Just ate a bunch of food, feeling better. Pile of fuzzy peaches, Oreos, mint Oreos, and this disgusting Havarti. It just got so soft, it was more like Havarti goo. I ate it, but it was, I had to stop. I got 3/4 of a block down just because I didn't want to do it again. Coming out Green Fork, it's looking pretty large. My hat keeps jostling around back there, making me thinking there's something behind me. Keeps scaring me. Oh, beautiful day. So good to be out. Look at this, eh? Just me and the moose and deer, it looks like. Straight Creek is like the entire valley. Just hiking the trail. No getting lost for me. Straight Creek. Alright.
I don't know if this is a bad idea, but I'm gonna try rafting straight creek. I was gonna not do it earlier because it looked crazy, but it doesn't look silly now. And I'm feeling good, I'm feeling alert with it, full of energy, so I'm just like, it just looks awesome. Here's what it looks like. There's a piece of wood there, and then away I go. Looks like it's moving. It's going. That last bit was a little spicy. A little class three, but I could see it was clear. That's the second one. Bailing out for wood's not actually that bad. You can just kind of auger into the willows and jump out. It's knee deep in the willows. Going good. Getting there. Man, the water looks tame in the videos. Bit of a nasty spot there. Nice, made her down Straight Creek. Wow, what a ride. That was awesome. That wasn't dumb, it was. I could do that. Well, it's the end of day one. Hiking a few more miles so I can put in first thing on the South Fork. I'd rather not put in first thing, but it's the way it works out, so. All right, morning of day two, 6 a.m. Time for a little whitewater for breakfast. Just trying to like do some squats, warm up a little. Water's just cruising here on the South Fork because of the sun. I put in 10 minutes ago and I'm already 3 miles down. All right, away we go. 7:30, done paddling the South Fork of the sun. And I'm heading up the North Fork of the sun. 28 miles to the pass and then another 7 or 8 to put in, 35 total. See if we get there today and still do some floating or not. It's a long ways. So the big consideration now is whether I can float the Middle Fork today. About 30 miles, it's 9:40. If I hustle, I could be there 7, best case. We're here at Moose Creek. I think it's Moose, something. It's gonna be a spicy ford. All right, that was a swimmer. Whew, that was full on. Kind of went out, it was knee deep, it was thigh, it was kind of 2/3. It's like, we can do this. And then it was just like, waist deep and sliding and sliding. Lost the trekking pole too, just got one now. Thankfully it was my old one. All right, I made it across Moose Creek back there, barely. Just so those people that don't have rafts don't have any excuses for not getting across these creeks, but now here at Rock Creek, I've learned my lesson. I'm gonna blow up the boat. Do I look beat up yet? I probably got like charcoal on my face or something. Always happens in these movies. I'll have some blisters by the end of the day. End of today or... Gates Park. A little behind schedule with these tough creek crossings. Plan now is to just make it to the Middle Fork tonight. Raft first thing. I'm here at Lick Creek. It's not a good scene. I have to make it across to that eddy right there. Or you go for a nice ride. Okay, I made it. Fast little ferry, hit the eddy, didn't hit all that. Man, the water levels are completely insane this year. I've never seen anything like it. Like, there's no way you're crossing Strawberry at the start of the Middle Fork on foot. I barely want to cross these things with a pack raft.
Jeez.
been a lot of deadfall in the sun. It's slowing me down. Man, this is a serious burn zone. It's making things tough. I'm trying to get over Sun River Pass by 7:30. And then 2 hours down to Strawberry Creek. Hopefully cross that at 9:30 with a bit of daylight left. Then I can walk a couple more miles. Oh yeah. Awesome. Well, getting near the end of day two. I'm getting there. I'm over Sun River Pass, coming down to the Middle Fork. Doing pretty good, knees are good. Bottoms of my feet are sore, that always happens. They get wet and prune up and then start to blister. So I got a few blisters. That's fun. You just pop them and keep walking. Well, my feet are pretty beat. I'm gonna try to have a fire, dry my shoes and socks, and then try to keep them dry for the road walk tomorrow. Otherwise, it's just gonna be game over on the feet.
Six a.m. day three, jumping into the Middle Fork Flathead.
Putting back in after three forks, or mostly after. It's pretty high water, just overflowing everywhere. Well, I went for another swimmer there on the Middle Fork. There was a big hole I was trying to cut and cross across in front of it to get to a nicer line on the other side, but there's a big side current. Ended up just going right through it. And thankfully I grabbed my boat, everything, paddle, didn't lose anything. Flipped the boat, re-entered pretty well. Flipping the boat was hard, but getting back in went pretty smooth. So I'm heading out Granite Creek, 6 miles to the road, and then 10 more to Marius Pass. Not really what I need right now. Oh, this is amazing. Somebody has come up here this year and sawed the logs. The last 4 miles have been just a log every 40 meters. In the first of that. Here's Granite Creek. It's got a little zip to it. Across Granite Creek, went reasonably well. Tough ford though. We wouldn't want it much deeper than that. I think the only way you could finish the Bob Open this year would be if you had all the creek crossing tools. So you need a packraft, strong fording skills, good eye for choosing safe logs to get across, and a lot of luck. And even then, you gotta really think about what you're doing, because if you make some epic ford to get across something, and then you can't get across the next one, you can wind up stuck. I've made it to Granite Creek Trailhead. It's awesome. 10 miles or so to go. You can see Glacier. It's a nice view, it keeps me going. The good part of a road walk is you got lots of time to think about what you should eat when you're done. Oh yeah, what a long event-filled journey. That was hard. Oh, my feet are sore. I mean, pretty good considering, but ow. Fun little section here of off-trail. See if we can navigate our way to that massive obelisk. Awesome. 7:20, 7:19.